Hello everybody, I'm Nicola Lombardi, the marketing manager of Lombardi Converting Machinery, and welcome to Plexo World, our virtual trade show. Today is the day for the mid-web, and as usual, I bring you into Lombardi technology with a special mid-web demo. Thank you for connecting with us during this day, and thank you for writing us and to collaborate with us. This is a special moment for our company. Let's see today the Invicta i1 and let's go a little bit deeper into this kind of press. Today we will see the Invicta i1 670, a press for the mid-web and for flexible packaging. Let's see the configuration. The unwinder unit is able to lift more than 1,000 kilograms. The web guide, the cleaner, the corona treatment, and we have 10 printing units combined, mixed with rotogravure technology and flexographic technology. 3 rotogravure units and 7 flexographic units. The printing length of each cylinder is ranging from 12 inches to 32 inches. And this press is full automated with automatic pre-register and register control, gearless with sleeve technology. Another feat of this press are the automatic pressures. 2 turnbar units and a converting unit, a special converting unit. In the end, as usual, there is the easy waste to reduce the waste of the material and 2 rewinder units. Today we are ready to print on PVC material of 50 micron with a job made of 6 color at a speed of 220 meters per minute. After this demo, we will have a special focus powered by BST Groups with Roberto Maiocchi. Stay tuned and let's start with the demo. Here we are. Let's see the final result of today's live demo. This is the official artwork of FlexoWorld, printed on PVC material for sleeve application. I wanna say thank you to anyone that are watching, that are writing to us during these 3 days of virtual event FlexoWorld. This is all from Lombardy Arena, but before move to a special focus, I wanna say thank you to Rotolificio Bergamasco for have requested this amazing Invicta with this special configuration for a flexible packaging focused on sustainability. Now, as I promised to you, we have a special focus about inspection and quality system powered by Roberto Maiocchi from BST Group.
Thank you for the introduction and hello to all our followers. My name is Roberto Maiocchi and I'm the Area Sales Manager of BST Group for the narrow and middle web market in Italy. As most of you probably already know, BST Group, member of Electrics Group together with EMG, Ecuma and Leys and Nyquist System, is a worldwide leading manufacturer of automation and control quality solution for the printing and converting market. After several years of cooperation with Lombardy Converting Machinery Company, we are very proud to be invited here at the first FlexoWorld event to present how the BST equipments are integrated into the Lombardy machines and in general in the printing press applications. Today, I will take advantage of this fantastic blue carpet to have a walk along the press and show you the integration of BST system, trying to explain how our equipments help the printers during the production activities. Let's start from the unwinder. And just at the beginning of the press, we have here the first BST system installed, the Web Alignment System Compact Guide. Since 1978, BST is a worldwide provider of solution of web alignment system application in different markets like printing, converting, tire industry, no woven, and in the last year we developed also special solution for solar cells and battery production. The perfect alignment is one of the elements which help our customer to satisfy the high quality demand of the market. With a good alignment, in fact, can ensure a waste reduction for lateral movement, so a better side register control during the process. In that case, our compact guide is equipped with ultrasonic sensor for edge guiding, which allow a perfect performance on different kind of substrate like opaque, reflective, transparent films, and optionally we can offer, of course, different kind of sensor for special application like infrared, wide array, and color line sensors. So the compact guide here is equipped also with a smart supply stable solution, complete of pneumatic clamping bars and tape dispenser designed by BST expert for allow as much as easier as possible the splice operation during the job change. Okay, so now we walk along the press. And just after the last printing unit, we can find the second system installed on that machine. So here we have the automatic register control system ER4400. ER4400 is a smart and flexible register control used especially in the narrow web application to ensure the higher precise colors and tool register in longitudinal and transversal direction. Thanks to the intelligent camera head, the system read micro dot register marks, and since from the setup of the production, it starts measuring the dots, distances, adjusting so in length and side direction the color alignment. The R4400 with a single camera head is able to control up to 12 printing units in mark-to-mark mode and eventually additional tooling station in mark-to-cylinder mode. Furthermore, ER4400 should be combined with additional camera for controlling the front and back register, for example, or for additional groups. With only one ER4400, we should connect up to 10 camera units for maximum 24 control units controlled. The interaction with the operator is really easy thanks to the intuitive 23-inch touch monitor user interface, from where the operator shall monitor the register trend and control the camera head performances due to the live image showed. The integration with the Lombardi press in that case is really particular because the system communicates with the press by a bus field protocol. And thanks to the special software developed by the Lombardi engineers, the results of the measurements are added to the results provided by the Lombardi register control plates on each unit, ensuring so a high standard level of precision and fast correction in longitudinal and transversal side. The R4400 has all BST and Eltromat series register controls solution ensure a long list of benefits like reduction of the time for the press setup, maximum quality, increased productivity, minimized paper waste, so higher customer satisfaction and sensitive production cost reduction. So the return of investment is improved. Few steps again, and then we find the third BST system installed on the Lombardi Invicta press, the PowerScope 5000. PowerScope 5000 digital video is a system provided by BST, which particularly meets the requirements of label and packaging printing industry, especially in the narrow web applications. PowerScope 5000 combines state-of-the-art technology with a user-friendly interface, while being perfectly adapted to the requirements of modern printing machines. The BST system uses a compact digital camera for excellent image quality and includes a number of innovative features for the unique for entry-level web monitoring. Just like its predecessor 3000 and 4000 series, the PowerScope 5000 meets the established criteria of excellent value for money, simple operation, robustness and reliability. Easy to understand how the printers, thanks to our web viewing system, are helped in monitoring the colors during the production, monitoring so at very high speed what with the human eyes could not be possible to look. And again, few steps, and I'm really proud to show you all the most innovative and cost-efficient 100% inspection system of the market. TubeScan Digital Strobe, provided by Nyquist System, SA, part of Elexis Group. With more than 1,500 systems sold in only 5 years, the 100% inspection system TubeScan is the most flexible and complete solution for the quality inspection of label and packaging in the narrow and middle web printing market. Suitable for application on slitting rewinders as well on printing press, TubeScan platform should cover and monitor the complete production workflow. We have the possibility to cover web width from 120 to 1,500 millimeter with several combination of hardware and software solutions in order to match perfectly the customer demands. The TubeScan digital strobe, in fact, could be configured with 2K, 4K and 6K camera solutions, different illumination like front, back, contouring, or as well with UV or infrared illumination for inspection of invisible inks. With also different optional solution, software solution, we help the operators to check in detail the 100% of the production. The main software of inspection allows to set easily a reference image which will be combined with all production, identifying all kind of error which occurs during the production, like mixing text, splashes, dirty, color deviation, and so on. Furthermore, with an additional modular concept, we can offer software modules with specific inspection, like PDF validation module, Delta E color monitoring, relative distance monitoring and repeat length monitoring, and barcode or OCR static or variable data control. And of course, with our Q-Link platform, all the workflow solution for the whole production. TubeScan is suitable for all kinds of material, like paper, film, foils, holograms. So without any kind of additional tools and cost, of course, we can inspect in opaque or reflective mode, ensuring the maximum production quality. The user interface is composed by a 15-inch touch monitor for the main setting operation and a viewing monitor from where the operator should monitor, control, and look all the all repeat, and in case of defect found, analyze the problem and provide necessary action. Let me say that thanks to the modular, intelligent, cost-efficient concept, the TubeScan product series reinvented the print inspection. So, my walk along the press is finished now. I hope that you enjoyed my presentation. I would like to invite you to visit BST Group virtual platform, website or social media, and to follow all the news regarding BST applications. In alternative, you can also, as usual, contact your local reference in our worldwide organization for more detailed information. Thanks again to Lombardi Converting Machinery for the opportunity gave me today to be here at the first Flex Award event. And a big thank you to all of you for your attention. Stay healthy and stay connected.
Good morning, everyone. This is Flexo World, the digital event organized by Lombardi. I am Giovanni Pergo, Global Sales Director for Lombardi Converting Machinery. Today we are here to talk about packaging. So for Lombardi, packaging is not only short runs on narrow web label presses, but we are present in this sector with two different machines called Invicta 1 and Invicta 2, which are the medium web presses for this market. Invicta 1 starts at 430 millimeter wide, but we also have a 530 as well as 650 millimeter machine. Invicta 2 is starting at 730, then we have 830 and 1 meter wide. Invicta 1 is a press with a maximum speed of 200 meters per minute. It's a sleeve press, but the analog is still a cylinder. The Invicta 2 is a sleeve press for both the plate and the analog, and the speed can be up to 300 meters per minute. These machines are mainly equipped with mercury UV lamps, but we have made machines with LED as well. On top of this, we have been discussing for application into the electron beam sector. Furthermore, we have developed in the years some water-based or solvent-based drying hoods for high-end applications like coating and special varnishes. These machines are available for test at our factory whenever the customer wants. We are here to serve and help our customer in deciding for the better press for their needs, whether that is a narrow press or a mid-web press. Packaging is a growing market. There is a higher demand of packaged product, both in water-based, solvent, UV, or LED. We are here to serve all our customers with state-of-the-art technology and the latest technology available in the market. Invicta I1 and Invicta I2 are mid-web presses. These presses are quick-change presses, so they can challenge central impression machines in the arena of flexible packaging. They are full servo, they are sleeves, and they have features like motorized pressure. So they have all the features to compete with high-end technology like central impression machines. These machines are good and interesting for the flexible packaging. In more in details, they can be used for production of flexible packaging of generic use, sleeves, IML. They can be used to print paper. They can be used to print aluminum for pharma or for lids application. They can print light carton and medium thickness carton for boxes. All these machines are connected as well as we are all doing with Lombardi presses. All our customers are linked with us through the web. With that, we can do remote diagnostics and we can do preventive diagnostics so that we minimize the downtime of our customers. These machines are really interesting for the packaging of today's world, where the demand of just-in-time short run is increasing the value of packaging into the world. Both Invicta 1 and Invicta 2 can be equipped with UV, LED, as well as water-based or solvent-based dryers. This machine can effectively print all these type of inks, as well as we can perform a lamination, or we can add a rotogravure unit for varnish or for technical layers. We can have open chamber doctor blade, as well as closed chamber with viscosity control. The machines have the latest software developed on Siemens platform by Lombardi technicians. The machines feature by standard automatic pre-register, automatic register, as well as print change capabilities. We have all the features that are needed for the flexible packaging market of today. Please follow us on social media, LinkedIn, Facebook, or give us a call and ask for a dedicated demo on a specific product or technology. We are here to help. Thank you very much.
Buongiorno a tutti, sono Enrico Gandolfi, direttore commerciale Italia per la ditta Lombardi. Oggi vi do il benvenuto al FlexoWorld Trade Show, Virtual Trade Show appunto. È questo evento che abbiamo pensato insieme a Nicola di organizzare per, come abbiamo detto nelle altre giornate, ovviare a quello che è stato un discorso di poca presenza nelle fiere o pressoché azzerata a causa di quanto è successo. Mi fa molto piacere dedicare questi minuti al discorso Flexible Lombardi nel Flexible Packaging. Non più tardi di circa 3 anni fa, quando mi sono presentato alla platea, sempre davanti a un'intervista, ho detto che per me era importante e era una mission insieme alla ditta Lombardi quella di cercare di affrontare il mercato del Flexible Packaging, dove fino ad allora la Lombardi era stata abbastanza marginale. Beh, devo dire che in questi anni di cose ne sono state fatte. Sono state fatte innanzitutto delle installazioni molto importanti, potrei citarne una su tutte, la macchina installata a Costanzia, secondo gruppo in Europa, quarto nel mondo, e anche ad altre realtà italiane molto interessanti. Cosa ha fatto Lombardi per quanto concerne la macchina, le macchine nel flexible packaging? Ovviamente sempre con la massima attenzione alla sostenibilità, dalla quale non possiamo mai prescindere, abbiamo sviluppato in maniera sempre più importante la nostra linea Invicta. Linea Invicta che forniamo nelle fasce carta 4.30, 5.30 e 6.50. Nei primi due casi direi relativamente ancora le etichette, nella 6.50 con un passaggio carta 6.70 e stampa 6.50 cominciamo ad approcciare quello che è in maniera importante il flexible packaging. Con l'Invicta 2, erede appunto o sorella maggiore della Invicta 1, siamo andati proprio a cercare di entrare in quello che è la fascia, che a questo punto non è più narrow, ma direi mid in qualche modo e anche oltre, del 750 mm, 850 e 1100. In queste macchine che noi facciamo in linea per il flexible packaging possiamo ovviamente mettere tutte le tecnologie a noi note. Diciamo che principalmente le macchine per il mercato a cui si rivolgono sono combinate con dei gruppi flexo, gruppi rotocalco, lamine e quant'altro. Una cosa molto importante oggi sono, diciamo, le diverse possibilità che abbiamo per l'asciugamento e polimerizzazione dell'inchiostro. Ormai non è più diciamo cosa esclusiva il discorso del LED, che comincia sempre più a prendere la parte in queste tipologie di stampa. Ovviamente la stampa classica con UV, l'asciugamento con UV al mercurio, ovviamente l'utilizzo di inchiostri base acqua con asciugamento ad aria calda ventilata oppure con batterie IR, e ancora sempre in minor parte appunto per un discorso green, il discorso al solvente anch'esso asciugato con aria calda e IR. Un altro approccio molto interessante che abbiamo avuto a un'altra tipologia di tecnologia che gravita attorno all'inflexible packaging è il sistema Electron Beam, particolare sistema di asciugamento, dove non starò a essere diciamo troppo tecnico su quello che è quello che va a fare, ma che in ottica di certificazione BRC, contatto diretto con alimenti o quant'altro, può in qualche modo dire la sua anch'esso. Cos'altro dire? Nel flexible packaging che si rivolge a quelle che sono le linee come le nostre, è importantissimo cercare di avere dei tempi di setup che siano il più basso possibile, perché nel qual caso il cliente avesse bisogno di tirature importanti, non dobbiamo essere noi a dirlo, ma ben sappiamo che ci sono macchine come le tamburo centrali che ben si prestano a quel tipo di produzione. La capacità nostra invece deve essere quella, o dei nostri clienti, di andare a intercettare quelle tirature che le aziende che hanno solo tecnologia central impression, quindi tamburo centrali, non possono, o meglio, no, a loro non conviene fare, in quanto tirature troppo piccole. In questo modo intervengono le nostre tipologie di macchine che, appunto, con cambi lavoro molto rapidi, ergonomia molto spinta, se noi andiamo a pensare il fatto che dover operare su una macchina tamburo centrale ovviamente comporta il fatto di operare ad elevate altezze, macchine molto ingombranti, eccetera eccetera. Invece una nostra linea per il flexible packaging è poco più che una macchina per etichette, per assurdo, quindi io mi trovo a lavorare su macchine in linea con degli ingombri contenuti e quindi con un'ergonomia e una facilità d'uso molto spiccate. Dove siamo stati, secondo me, particolarmente attenti e bravi? Noi nelle nostre macchine, soprattutto nella famiglia Invicta, siamo andati a motorizzare tutto ciò che doveva in qualche modo muoversi. Abbiamo i tre assi principali motorizzati, che sono l'anox, portacliché e il contrasto, abbiamo tutte le pressioni motorizzate, abbiamo la discesa in posizione della manica da stampa motorizzata, possiamo ricettare tutto ciò che noi motorizziamo, e quindi qui mi rifaccio ben volentieri a un discorso di azienda 4.0 che, con tutti i sistemi ormai da noi messi sul campo, ha raggiunto un livello elevatissimo di interfacciamento tra quello che è, diciamo, la parte produttiva dello stabilimento con quello che è la parte di programmazione e produzione. Altro aspetto fondamentale che abbiamo ritenuto di dover affrontare, anche qui non vorrei entrare troppo nello specifico tecnico, ma nell'Invicta E2 abbiamo cercato di allontanarci da quello che era il classico sistema, diciamo, che quasi tutti adottano a triangolo, sto pensando a cilindro Hanlock, porta cliché e contrasto, ma abbiamo abbandonato questo sistema per andare su un sistema lineare. Perché, chiederete voi, abbiamo fatto ciò? Perché con un sistema lineare noi abbiamo potuto arrivare a sviluppi di 36 pollici, oltre 900 mm, che se noi andiamo a pensare in una macchina larga 1100, possiamo tranquillamente affermare di essere tra i pochi al mondo, o forse gli unici, nelle macchine in linea che possono stampare sino a 1 m², se consideriamo lo sviluppo e la larghezza nastro. Cos'altro dire? Nel flexible packaging è molto importante cercare di mantenere la costanza di qualità e quello che è un discorso di economicità per certe situazioni. Da qui il fatto di utilizzare magari, ad esempio, i gruppi rotocalco che non possono prescindere per certe stampe di chiusura, di fondopieni o quant'altro, oppure in altri casi sono più indicati per stampare certi tipi di inchiostro metallizzati e quant'altro. Diciamo che la sfida che noi avevamo pensato di affrontare ancor prima del mio arrivo, la famiglia Lombardi e insieme a me, successivamente a me, anche Giovanni, abbiamo cercato di affrontare, diciamo che siamo riusciti in qualche modo e i numeri ci stanno dando ragione. Quindi, se mai Lombardi fosse stata, diciamo, meno presente che nel narrowweb, dove ormai, per esempio, in certi mercati come quello italiano potremmo considerarla, se non la numero uno numericamente parlando, con un numero di macchine installate negli ultimi anni, la numero due al massimo, diciamo che la nostra voglia, la nostra volontà è quella di arrivare anche in quelle che sono le linee da flexible packaging a raggiungere i numeri molto interessanti in tutto il mondo anche in questo settore, e così potremo dire di avere raggiunto gli ottimi risultati da noi sperati. Vi saluto dicendo che quando io promisi ai Lombardi che avrei fatto il possibile per cercare di spingere sempre di più le nostre macchine in questo settore, sentivo gravare su di me una grande responsabilità, e direi che fino ad oggi e in questo giorno che vi sto parlando posso dire di avere abbastanza rispettato le attese, e quindi ben venga che la Lombardi aumenti la sua presenza in questo tipo di settore insieme a me, insieme a Giovanni, insieme a tutti gli altri. Vi saluto e vi ringrazio. Salve.
where every gear perfectly fit together, allowing a smooth overall performance and giving our customer a positive experience. Now, let us dive deeper to know better the three teams composing our service department. First, we have the remote service team, dedicated entirely to solve our customers' problems by providing immediate remote support with maximum competence. After the front office forwards the client's call, they firstly provide remote assistance on the phone or online, trying to understand better what is needed. Once they figure the issue, they report it to the relevant department, where they will manage and resolve it. Our technicians are always online and able to overcome every possible issue and support the customers during production problems on the spot. Secondly, we have the spare parts team, which job is to check, pack, and ship the goods from our warehouse to our customers all over the world. Here in the warehouse, the spare parts team carries out a quality control of all materials in departure or arrival. They carefully sort every part and organize them in the warehouse to avoid any possible mistake. And they prepare the goods for the customer with precision and care, in order to have a perfect delivery with no damage to the parts. Thanks to this working method, we are able to ship worldwide with 24 hours, meeting the high standards and urgencies of our customers. Last but not least, we have the training team, which is completely dedicated to installation and testing of our machines in order to ensure the functioning and the highest quality of the final product. They are our first responders in case the issue needs to be fixed on site. After consulting with the remote service and spare parts team, they schedule on-site intervention, provide remote and on-site installation support, provide remote and on-site training for operators on Lombardi's system. They also train Lombardi's technicians all over the world to have an even quicker response for our customers, and they carry out webinars every day for customers to give them advices and solutions to improve their production.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Ramesh Bajaj, and I'm a director at the WinSec Group. WinSec, as you may know, we are the distributors for the Lombardi manufacturing company for India, for Middle East, and Africa. Today, I need to talk about flexible packaging, as Niccolo Lombardi asked me to do, and I just wanted to discuss with you the flexible packaging market in our region. In our region of India, Middle East, and the English-speaking part of Africa, the current size of the flexible packaging, just the flexible packaging market, is ahead of $45 billion US dollars per annum, and it's growing at a healthy 6 to 6.5%. The biggest growth drivers have been two, I think. One has been the growth in retail, organized retail, and the second has been the growth in e-commerce. If you look at organized retail, more and more products are now being packaged, especially after this pandemic, where earlier some products were being sold loose or in poor quality packaging. Today, hygiene and quality of packaging have become paramount. So why is this growth coming from? Like we said, there are three key drivers for this growth. The first driver is, of course, the increasing disposable income, especially in the markets which are developing economies of India, of Middle East, some part of the Middle East, if not the well-developed countries like the UAE. And also for the eastern part of Africa, there is a continuous growth in the disposable income. And when a person's income grows, the first thing they choose is to buy better quality food or products which are packaged well. So, rather than buying an open piece of food from the street. If I make a little more money, I will go to a store and prefer to buy something which is nicely packaged, making sure it's hygienically packed, and hence it's something which I'm sure is going to be good for my health. So this has been a key driver in terms of increasing the consumption. The other thing is that also there is an urge for premiumization. You will see that as the disposable income of a country goes up, the sale of premium product goes up. How do we know that a product is premium? The differentiator is usually the packaging. The first impact is from the packaging. So if you have premium looking packaging, something which is attractive, which has a lot of maybe foiling or gold foiling or embossing, or you see the new Fresnel lens effects, all these add value to the packaging. And hence, because they attract the consumer to buy on a store shelf, their sales are better. So more and more companies are looking at, making their packaging more premium. And hence there is the interest to add technology to improve the packaging premiumization. The second point of discussion here is to increase the longer shelf life that you need, and innovation. So packaging always has been all about functionality, and it's not only about aesthetics. Creating a nice stand-up pouch to replace a plastic bottle or a disposable bottle is what the future is all about. You will see more and more, drinking liquids being sold in plastic pouches with a nice spout on top, which will be easier to manufacture, lighter weight, so easier to transport, and hence it will be more economical for the whole supply chain. The third but the most important part I have also seen is the emphasis on sustainability. Brands are becoming more and more aware that we need to be sustainable in our outlook. Customers want to buy from a brand that not only is sustainable, but is also able to communicate to the end consumer that they are doing sustainable actions per se. You see all this development in new materials. You have these starch, polymer-based or plant-based polymers, starch-based films, all these new materials, wooden-based cutlery, or edible cutlery. All these products are now catching the fancy of consumers, and there that emphasis is going to make sure that packaging continues to grow in these markets. The other key driver is, or the key growth area, has been e-commerce. As you can see, that because of restrictions of movement during the pandemic, plus the ease of operation, the new generation or the millennials continue to use e-commerce over a continued period of time for anything and everything they buy. Earlier we were all visiting a retail store on a daily basis or at least a twice weekly basis to pick up our stuff. And now more and more we just order it online and make it delivered to us. For maintaining the quality and hygiene of the product, I think it's essential that the product is packaged in a proper way. Plastics, as we all know, or flexibles, provide the best weight to performance ratio that any other raw material can provide. The barrier properties that plastic brings to us, the lightweight that it does, the longevity or the ability to seal in freshness of fresh food for a longer period of time are all within the plastics. We all hear plastics are bad, plastics are not good, or flexible packaging is difficult, but we must also understand that the correction that we need to do in the system is about the recyclability of the plastics. If we can get a responsible recyclability solved, we are sure that plastic and flexible packaging can become a key component of our lives and continue to be the preferred choice for all our brands. Brands are now becoming responsible themselves to individually mark each pack in many cases, and also have a reverse vending or a reverse collection mechanism to be able to report that, okay, if we put out 100 tons of plastic in the market, there is 75 tons or 50 tons that we collected back, and we have recycled it effectively. You see the new rPET fabric, you see the new rPET yarn, you see new rPET bottles. Key cases today, virgin materials are cheaper than recycled materials. Recycled PET today is at $1,300 per ton versus virgin PET being available at maybe $800 a ton or $750 a ton, which shows that the demand for recycled material is growing, and this will make sure that the industry will catch up and there will be more and more recyclability coming into the market. So to discuss what Lombardi has been doing in the flexible packaging market, see, we all know that with the new norms, government norms, gravure, solvent-based gravure is getting banned by governments around the world. So more and more flexible packaging is moving to Flexo. Earlier it was more CI Flexo. However, in widths of because short runs have become shorter and SKUs are becoming more, people are now preferring to run a narrower width press. So whatever was done in 1 meter width for a million, you know, SKUs is now being done, say, for 100,000 SKUs in a 500 mm wide press. So initially, Lombardi, we sold a number of Lombardi presses printing flexible packaging in widths of 450, 550, or even up to 620 mm. Now, after Lombardi launched the new i2 press, we have a huge market where we are taking on even for the medium to long runs. The preference of buying an inline flexo over a CI flexo press. The inline flexo gives you the same flexibility in terms of quick changeover, much almost similar or even sometimes lower cost of owning such a machine, and the ability to run more jobs per day, or like more different jobs per day than a large CI press. We think there is a huge potential there to grow this business of flexible packaging using inline flexo, whether it be UV based or water based, with the new low migration inks, the new LED cured inks which are coming in. It's an exciting space to be in. So all the best, be safe during the pandemic, and let's look at growing together the business of flexible packaging using Lombardi machines. Oh, wow.
Hello everybody, welcome to FlexoWorld. Today's topic is flexible packaging. And as usual, I'm ready to bring you into Lombardi technology with today the Invicta i2, the brand new press developed for high quality flexible packaging. This press is gearless, shaftless, and direct drive on the three main elements of the printing unit, such as the sleeve shaft, the anti-lock shaft, and the drum shaft. Thanks to this and to a frame featuring 50 meter shoulders, the machine delivers guaranteed quality. Invicta i2 can be realized in different sizes, 750, 850, and 1100. That means that the operator can print 1 square meter of material. Like all Lombardi presses, our technology is full modular. So let's see in detail the configuration of Invicta i2. The first unit is the Unwinder unit, followed by the web guide that gives you the possibility to control the right direction of the material. The corona treatment and the cleaner to remove the dust on the material. Invicta i2 of today is composed by 9 flexo color group with can have a maximum development of 36 inks. The press can print any type of filmic material and aluminium as low as 12 micron. This press can print plastic films for roll feed, shrink and stretch application, as well as multi-substrate aluminium and light carton. Equipped with automatic register control and pre-register control, with a panel on each flexo color group that gives the operator user friendliness and simplicity of use, this press reduces drastically the waste of time for each setup of the press. The turn bar unit gives you the possibility to print on the front side and on the back side of the material. And 4 monitors on the press give to the operator the possibility to check in real time the accuracy of the register during the print. Let's see how simple the flexo color group of the Invicta i2 is. Our operator enables the command to insert the iron inside the shaft on which the anti-lock sleeve will be positioned. Anti-lock axis locking, enabling a command for print sleeve shaft iron, sleeve insertion for cliché, plate axis locking, flexo color group closing command in printing position, the anti-lock axis goes to meet with the closed chamber doctor blade. We bring the doctor blade in the printing position. The group is ready to print, enabling the command to bring the group in the right printing position. Thank you. Each FlexoColor group is equipped with UV mercury about the dry option, except the ninth FlexoColor group that thanks to the hot air dryer unit is able to print water-based ink and solvent-based ink. The control of the quality of the print is realized by 100% accuracy control powered by BST, and here we have the camera of register control. The master panel, intuitive, wide, simple for the operator, give you the possibility to control and check all the parameters of the work we are gonna doing. The rewinder unit in the end of the press. Today's live demo is a print on PP Clear material with five color, CYMK plus white, with a thickness of 50 micron. We are ready to print at a speed of 300 meters per minute. I'm ready to start the demo. Let's go. The final result of today's live demo. We have printed on a filmic material PP Clear of 50 micron thickness with five color, CYMK plus additional white. This is the quality you can reach with a press La Invicta i2. I want to say thank you to Maier Italia for the hospitality of this demo, and follow us in FlexoWorld for the next episode about flexible packaging. Hello everybody! Hello everyone, welcome to today's episode of FlexAward. Today we will speak about analogs and technical components. We are here with our guest, Silvia Caldiroli from Apex. Welcome to FlexAward.
Thank you so much, Nicola, for inviting me and Apex to be present today to this fantastic project, to be a part of that. We are so proud to be here, and thank you and Lombardi for having us here.
You are welcome.
Thank you.
So, let's start the interview. Who is Apex?
Apex International is a leader company that products Anilox RAW, glue sets and metering products in general. We have five production plants in four continents, different commercial offices around the world, and a network of 150 agents everywhere. It means that the mentality of Apex is to be a global company that acts locally.
Yes, fantastic. Today we want to speak about components, technical aspects, and I want to discuss about analogs. What
fantastic.
Is an analog?
An analog can be defined the heart of the printing machine. It means that analog is a simple roll or a sleeve that it's coated by a special ceramic layer and is engraved with a special beam, laser beam. The laser beam goes to pulverize the ceramic, and the result is a hole. This hole is called commonly cell. The number of cell in 1 centimeter is called lineature, and the capacity, the cap of the hole created is called volume. That's the definition of an analog.
Yes, it's interesting because the function of FlexAward is to try to speak about the many aspects of the flexography world, the FlexAward, and to make it understand to
exactly.
all our viewers from each part of the world.
Exactly.
So interesting about the analogs. And what is the difference between Apex and other analog manufacturers?
Okay, usually I don't want to make a comparison one between the other, but what I have to say to that Apex is in constant research of the technology development. So it means that you have to think that we are a worldwide company, and the 20% of our turnover is dedicated to the research and development. This is one of the big differences between us and other companies. Moreover, you have to think that we always think to a stock program for each customer. We have a very good cooperation with all the leaders in the market. So it means end user, OEMs, we have the co-seller. So we have a 360 degree aspect on our company. And this makes the difference. We can be also with our traceability program, we can be everywhere in the world with a simple serial number made on the analogs.
Yeah. So, research and development is the keyword, and this is one of the reasons that has brought Lombardi Converting Machinery to invite you in this virtual place to speak about. Research and development is the keyword in this difficult period to grow, to show something new and technologically sophisticated. What is the last technology that you have
When we speak about technology, research and development, the first thing I think from my company point of view is GTT.
Whoa.
You know that today technology is a partner that every company must have. It's not an option, it should be a must have. So we can say that our research and development department, starting from the idea, you know, we have our headquarters is in Holland. Holland is constantly fighting against water. That's the idea, the initial idea of GTT. So how they can constantly have a fluency on the channel, on the canals with the water, That's the idea of GTT, so having the same fluent and constant printing ink on the GTT printing.
Fantastic. I mentioned the GTT technology during our live demos on our presses. One of them is the press behind me, behind us. But this explanation is so interesting, and I think our viewers have understand the importance of this particular technology.
For sure. Even if you consider that the traditional cell, the engraving like an honeycomb has walls, this wall has a limit in itself. So all the technology, the traditional technology we are speaking about, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, ultra channel, channel locks, helicoidal, whatever is in the middle, has this kind of limit, so the wall. GTT is totally different because you don't have wall. It's a sort of snake, and this allows ink to be fluent and constant during the time.
So cool, so interesting, and so technologically sophisticated.
Thank you so much. That is what I wanted to hear today.
Another question is that in this 2020 there was a big change in communication from marketing manager to marketing manager. I want to ask you, what do you think about FlexAward and what do you think about the digital communication in our market?
I have to be sincere with you, as I told you, but I told you once that we were outside all this moment. I think that you are making the difference because this is the new way. This should be the new way of moving for everyone. And I think you are going to be the example for everyone to be followed. So many thanks to you for having us here.
Thank you so kind for these words. I'm so happy because Silvia is one of the first people that supported my project. And I want to say thank you to you because
you.
I spoke with you during last fair show, la physical trade show when were possible to realize. But now to realize this virtual trade show, I've had a big support from Silvia. So really, really thank you.
Thank you too.
I want to say thank you from Lombardi Converting Machinery for your support and your presence during virtual space in FlexAward.
Thank you so much. It was a pleasure to be here. And from my side and from Apex International side, we are proud to be here. Thank you so much, Nicola.
This was FlexAward. She was Silvia Caldiroli from Apex. Thank you everyone from Lombardi Converting Machinery.
Siamo da Lombardi alla manifestazione FlexAward e siamo a colloquio con Sante Conservar, direttore di IEC e Gamma Group, e un grande esperto nel settore della flexografia, e volevamo sottoporle appunto alcune domande proprio relative al settore che lui ben conosce, dove ricopre anche delle cariche istituzionali in associazioni di categoria. Come vede la tendenza del mercato nella flex in Italia nel settore etichette, anche in confronto alle altre tecniche di stampa e in abbinamento al digitale?
Il mercato del packaging è un mercato molto importante, ha un giro di affari di circa 1.000 miliardi all'anno, di cui un 1,5-2% è fatto solo dal mondo delle etichette. Negli ultimi anni il mercato di nicchia o il mercato delle etichette è un mercato che si è evoluto notevolmente, ha avuto grande innovazione, c'è stata un'introduzione di anche di grandi tecnologie, cioè nel senso che si è passati molto dalla offset a quello che è la flexo. Le etichette, il mondo delle etichette è sempre stato un mondo che ha utilizzato tutte le tecnologie di stampa, ma in particolare negli ultimi 20 anni la flexo è stata proprio un'esplosione, tant'è che oggi l'80% delle macchine che vengono acquistate sono tutte con flexo ed eventualmente poi con anche altre tecnologie, ma principalmente con flexo. Un altro, diciamo, fenomeno ovviamente è stato quello del digitale, anche se tuttora a livello mondiale il digitale rappresenta circa il 12-15% di tutto il volume delle etichette. Quello che è abbastanza importante, abbiamo notato che è la combinazione a volte della flexo con altre tecnologie, di cui anche il digitale. Quindi se la flexo sta facendo un po' da padrone, poi nel mondo delle etichette vengono applicate anche altre tecnologie di stampa per portare poi a una completezza e a una nobilitazione di quella che è l'etichetta.
Bene. Allora, passiamo alla seconda domanda che volevo farle. Quali sono le novità tecnologiche più interessanti e utili nel settore flexografico degli ultimi tempi? Finishing, controllo qualità, supporti?
Sicuramente c'è stata una grande evoluzione, dicevo prima, nel mondo delle etichette. Il mondo dell'etichetta non è più solo un'etichetta, ma è un mezzo di comunicazione che è stato notevolmente rivalutato, sia per motivi di informazione che dà su ogni prodotto. Viene utilizzato tantissimo per ciò che riguarda il neutro, dove viene rivalutato il prodotto, ipotesi bakery, dove la confezione è neutra, ma insieme all'etichetta viene già dato un valore aggiunto. Come ormai l'etichetta, quando poi ha anche una nobilitazione, cioè pensiamo ognuno di noi oggi se va a acquistare una bottiglia di vino, ovvio che a un certo punto è colpito moltissimo da una etichetta o come altri prodotti, quindi emozionalmente l'etichetta ci coinvolge e questo deriva dal fatto dell'utilizzo di tecnologie innovative sulla macchina da stampa, tecnologie di prodotto, perché sempre di più si va verso un mercato anche con molta attenzione all'ambiente, quindi dei supporti compostabili, dell'utilizzo di carta eventualmente anche riciclabile e inoltre anche utilizzando certe tecnologie che sono dei prodotti. Oggi si parla anche addirittura di vernici che sono antibatterici, quindi anche questo è una qualcosa. E poi direi inchiostri, che anche in questo caso a volte sono tattili, cioè la possibilità di simulare quello che può essere un tessuto piuttosto che un qualcosa a livello di buccia di banana. Quindi è tutto un mix di tecnologie, di utilizzo di tecnologie sulle macchine da stampa e di prodotti. Inoltre viene fatta apposta molta attenzione, essendo un mezzo di comunicazione, anche a quello che è la qualità. Ecco perché sempre di più i costruttori vanno ad utilizzare certi accessori come quello nel controllo della qualità con sistemi di ispezione, dove si vuole raggiungere il massimo, dove dalla stampa e non solo dalla sulla macchina da stampa, su eventualmente sui tavoli di controllo, deve assolutamente uscire un prodotto che sia il massimo a livello di qualità, cercando di ridurre drammaticamente quelli che sono poi gli scarti.
Certo, questo nell'ottica sempre che è l'etichetta quasi che, oltre ad essere un mezzo di comunicazione, determina l'importanza del prodotto molto spesso, come ha detto in precedenza.
Assolutamente, ecco. Perché, ripeto, a livello emozionale noi siamo colpiti oltre che dal prodotto, dal packaging e in molti casi, quando non c'è il packaging, da quello che porta una bottiglia, un contenitore dove questa etichetta risalta la qualità, applicando ovviamente poi anche dell'oro a caldo o altri tipi di tecnologie per portare al massimo livello questo tipo di prodotto.
Bene, allora ultima domanda, considerando la sua esperienza in alcuni ruoli istituzionali nel settore della flexografia, come posiziona i produttori italiani sia di macchine attrezzature sia come convertitori sul mercato internazionale?
Sicuramente nel campo in particolare della flexo, non solo della flexo, l'Italia è sempre stata all'apice. L'Italia ha insegnato molto a livello mondiale come attrezzature. Abbiamo una grande tradizione, una tradizione che è nata sul grande formato, che poi è stata riportata anche in quello che viene considerato il narrow web. Di conseguenza abbiamo un'eccellenza in Italia di costruttori che sono ben riconosciuti. L'Europa è la prima a livello mondiale per ciò che riguarda innovazione e l'Italia forse è la prima, senza il forse, a livello europeo. Quindi i costruttori italiani hanno avuto questa grande qualità di poter costruire, progettare delle attrezzature sia in termini di flessibilità, sia in termini di qualità e sia anche in termini proprio di ciò che viene stampato, perché ovviamente abbiamo tutta una tradizione. Lei prima mi diceva per ciò che riguarda anche il converter. Il converter italiano, la stampa a livello italiana è riconosciuta come tra le migliori a livello mondiale, tant'è che i nostri, diciamo, stampatori sono molto apprezzati a livello mondiale per ciò che generano, tenendo presente che comunque il mercato europeo è di circa 7 miliardi, quindi ci ritroviamo in una, l'Italia ha una bella fetta di questa nicchia di mercato, ma ripeto, su un prodotto che molte volte la stessa etichetta esalta il prodotto tradizionale del food italiano. Pensiamo ai vini, pensiamo alle etichette dei vini, pensiamo a tutto ciò che è il food italiano riconosciuto nel mondo, e l'etichetta è un ulteriore valore aggiunto a questi eccezionali prodotti dell'alimentare di marchio italiano.
Bene, allora ringraziamo Sante Conselvan per il suo intervento, anche a nome di Lombardi e di Meteprint Art, e grazie.